Hello everyone, I'm Amartya Kattayan, and before we begin with today's discussion, I would like to congratulate each one of you for completing your school life successfully. You are about to begin a new roller coaster ride in your life, and that is engineering. So congratulations on that. What is different between school life and your college life? In short, college life is more about exploring what is life itself? What do I mean when I say explore? I mean exploring the various opportunities that are yet to come in your life, exploring your interests and talents, exploring the hidden potentials in you, and exploring how to apply the things that you've been learning to solve real world problems. Today, I'll be sharing with you some tips and tricks that I've been using firsthand, which might be beneficial for you starting early. You might have this doubt that what is the academic aggregate that is required. So here is a list of certain things that you can keep in mind while setting a target. If you set your target above 60%, you will meet the minimum requirement for a company. Okay, so many companies that come, especially to the campus, they have a minimum requirement of 60%. There are various companies which may not have an aggregate requirement, but if they have a requirement, minimum is of 60%. Then you have, if you have 70 to 75% target, then all good companies that are coming to campus, you will be eligible for them. And since considering it is a pandemic situation and you all are studying from home, people will expect a bit more from you. So 80% and above, if you keep, you will be future proof. Considering a time 4 years ahead, 3 to 4 years ahead, you will be future proof for all the good companies, that is both on and off campus. Then, when it comes to books, how do you refer to books? In today's time, I would suggest you go for ebooks. That is available on websites like Library Genesis. You can search any engineering book that is mentioned on the syllabus in Library Genesis. Then you have College Library. Whenever you're going offline for offline lectures, you can issue books for 1 to 2 weeks from the college library. And if you would like to have a book of your own, I would suggest you to go for second-hand books that you can tie up with your seniors and take in half the rate instead of buying new books. It would save you cost and expenses. So what are the courses you should be taking? Which platform should you take it from? One of my favorite platforms is YouTube. Most of the engineering courses, you can get good contents from YouTube. Then there is a platform called Udemy. It is usually paid courses, but then there are coupon codes you should apply. If you use the right coupon code on the right courses, you might get it for free. So check out for those. NPTEL. NPTEL is a professional learning platform which is accredited and recognized by many companies. Then you have Coursera and edX. These are some good platforms too. You must check them out. What programming language should I learn first? So in my recommendation, learn at least one basic programming language properly, preferably C++, as it will introduce you to object-oriented programming concepts. And it will also help you when you start with competitive programming, which will open your gateway for most of the companies, as they are asked in the first stage itself. What is competitive programming? So to learn more about this, there can be much spoken on competitive programming. But if you want to start with competitive programming, you must make an account on HackerRank and explore competitive programming. It will be very helpful when it comes to coding interviews. It is highly recommended for beginners. Coding competitions. Try participating in various coding competitions whenever you get the opportunity. For example, IEEE Extreme, IEEE CSPL, competitions on HackerRank and CodeChef, etc. So these are some competitions that I personally have been a part of. That is a coding competition by Code Warriors. Recently, this was by CSPL, IEEE CSPL. This was a competition organized by a college itself on HackerRank platform. And this is a competition organized by Newton School. So I have been part of these coding competitions. Then mini projects and GitHub. When you learn a concept, a programming language or any concept that you feel you should apply try applying it. Try the practical approach. Try making projects out of it. Say, suppose you learn Java. Try making an app. If you make an app, upload it on GitHub. What will help you with that is when you are applying for internship, when you are trying for your first internship, these projects that you make, these mini projects that you make, that will help you get your first internship. You can also get an idea about open source when you try GitHub. And hackathons. Participate in hackathons like Smart India Hackathon, TI and AICTE, and project exhibitions like Kshitij. It will give you an exposure and the confidence to work in a team. These are two hackathons that I have been part of. One is by Texas Instruments and one is by Smart India Hackathon that was held in our college. So, internships. In second or third year, you'll be looking out for internships. What you must do is must keep an eye for internship opportunities that you get from the college, like with Cloud ConciliEdge and Fire. The projects you make in these internships will be worth speaking of when it comes to interviews. Here's a certificate that I got from Cloud ConciliEdge, being part of their internship. Campus ambassador programs. In the first year itself, you will be exposed to various campus ambassador programs that you can be a part of. It will give you the confidence to represent a company and learn more about it. Learn more about the company, their policies, etc. The hiring opportunities in the company. It is very beneficial. I had been a campus ambassador for Tata Consultancy Services. Cultural events and tech fests. You can organize and participate in cultural events, tech fests being held in our college like Inspirus as well as other colleges if you get a chance. It will boost your communication skills and power of expression, especially if you participate in competitions like debates, presentations, ideathons, and lectures. It will be really beneficial. This is an upcoming event that is Inspirus 2021. I hope to see you all there. Tech groups on WhatsApp and workshops in college. You can be a part of various tech groups like GDG DBC, Tech Geeks DBC, etc. Participate in various hands-on workshops which are organized by C Codes, IEEE, etc. It will help you explore technologies like AI, machine learning, data science, cloud computing, app development, robotic process automation, cybersecurity, blockchain, big data, web technologies. These are some fields and technologies you must explore. Sports and NSS. Participate in the sports which you like in inter-department and inter-college events like basketball, football, table tennis, badminton, and so on. Try volunteering in NSS as it will give you a sense of social responsibility as well as social awareness. Lastly, last but not the least, health is wealth. Health is wealth and must be our top priority. Do physical exercise daily and try to give yourself at least 6 hours of sleep. Thank you very much and hope you enjoy your day.